哋歡喜快樂嘅係嚟到敬拜復活嘅主，正如頭先 Handel's Messiah 尼賽亞神曲所講嘅 ，I know that my Redeemer liveth。我哋咧歡喜快樂嘅心，我哋感恩嘅心，頌讚嘅心，我哋咧每一個主日都係嚟到紀念主耶穌基督從死裏復活。首先，我哋安靜心靈，主在聖殿中 ，The Lord is in His Holy Temple。進堂詩第49首，請起立，同眾主名歌 Christ is the King。
教友早晨，
早晨，
哈利路亚！基督已经复活了，
主真的复活了，哈利路亚！
愿他的恩惠平安与你们同在，
愿他的平安与你们同在。
全能的上帝，凡人的心在主面前无不显明，心里所羡慕的主都知道，心里所隐藏的也瞒不过主。求主赐圣灵感化我们，洁净我们心思意念，使我们尽心爱主，恭敬归荣耀于主的圣名，这都是靠着我们的主耶稣基督。阿门。今天的祝文，全能永恒的上帝啊，你是信靠者的力量，是怀疑者的盼望，求主使我们这些未曾眼见的人能有信心去领受基督传备的祝福。他是复活的主，以圣父、圣灵同一上帝一同掌权，从今直至永远。阿门。现在是教育的经课，请坐。
第一次的经课是记载在约翰一书，论到从起初原有的生命之道，就是我们所听见、所看见、亲眼看过、亲手摸过的，这生命已经显现出来，我们也看见过，现在又作见证，将原与父同在且显现于我们那永远的生命传给你们。我们将所看见、所听见的传给你们，使你们与我们相交。我们乃是与父并他儿子耶稣基督相交的。我们将这些话写给你们，使你们的喜乐充足。神就是光，在他毫无黑暗。这是我们从主所听见又报给你们的信息。我们若说是与神相交，却仍在黑暗里行，就是说谎话，不行真理了。我们若在光明中行，如同神在光明中，就彼此相交。他儿子耶稣的血也洗净我们一切的罪。我们若说自己无罪，便是自欺，真理不在我们心里了。我们若认自己的罪，神是信实的，是公义的，必要赦免我们的罪，洗净我们一切的不义。我们若说自己没有犯过罪，便是以神为说谎的，他的道也不在我们心里了。我小子们啊，我将这些话写给你们，是要纪念，是要叫你们不犯罪。若有人犯罪，在父那里我们有一位中保，就是那义者耶稣基督。他为我们的罪做了挽回祭，不是单为我们的罪，也是为普天下人的罪。这是上主的道，感谢上主。
现在是诗篇的时间，今天的诗篇是选自133篇，会众请一起同读。看啊，弟兄和睦同居是何等地善，何等地美。这些好比那贵重的油，晓在亚伦的头上，流到胡须，又流到他的衣襟。又好比黑门的金露，降在锡安山，因为在那里有耶和华所命定的福，就是永远的生命。但愿荣耀归于圣父、圣子、圣灵。起初这样，现在这样，将来也这样，永无穷尽。阿门。请起立同唱福音诗。
阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿门。阿
今日聖福音記載在約翰福音第二十章十九節起。那日就是七日的第一日晚上，門徒所在的地方，因怕猶太人，門都關了。耶穌來站在當中，對他們說：願你們平安。說了這話，就把手和肋旁指給他們看。門徒看見主，就喜樂了。耶穌又對他們說：願你們平安，父怎樣差遣了我，我也照樣差遣你們。說了這話，就向他們吹一口氣，說：你們受聖靈，你們赦免誰的罪，誰的罪就赦免了；你們留下誰的罪，誰的罪就留下了。那十二個門徒中有稱為低土馬的多馬，耶穌來的時候，他沒有和他們同在。那些門徒就對他說：我們已經看見主了。多馬卻說：我非看見他手上的釘痕，用指頭探入那釘痕，又用手探入他的肋旁，我總不信。過了八日，門徒又在屋裏，多馬也和他們同在，門都關了。耶穌來站在當中說：願你們平安。就對多馬說：伸過你的指頭來，摸我的手，伸出你的手來，探入我的肋旁，不要疑惑，總要信。多馬說：我的主，我的神。耶穌對他說：你因看見了我才信，那沒有看見就信的有福了。耶穌在門徒面前另外行了許多神蹟，沒有記在這書上，但記這些事要叫你們信耶穌是基督，是神的兒子，並且叫你們信了他，就可以因他的名得生命。這是上主的福音。
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Please be seated. Tomorrow is just going to be amazing. We have the eclipse of the sun, probably the only one we'll have in our whole lifetime. It's very, very exciting. Are you getting excited and getting your glasses, your pinhole cameras ready? It will be just remarkable. And I've been told that so many things happen in that moment that aren't just the shadows, but the birds and the animals, and it's quite an awe-inspiring experience. And they said in an article in the paper yesterday that it's a collective experience. It's something we're all going to go through. And so it builds a sense of awe and wonder in all of us. And that kind of awe, that sense that we are part of something greater than ourselves, can change people right from the inside out. They have a sense of being in community with other people. They have a sense of more understanding and more sympathy. So it's going to be amazing. It'll be quite a blessing to go through tomorrow. And I was thinking that this passage that Gabriel just read for us from St. John is a real blessing too. It's full of blessings for us And one thing that really struck me this year is when Jesus said to Thomas, "Have you believed because you have seen? Blessed are those who have not seen and have yet come to believe." Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe. Well, that's us, all the way from St. Thomas through to us. We haven't seen, but we have this blessing of belief, this actual blessing that Jesus is giving to us, a blessing poured out for us, his love, his care, and his presence with us, giving us life and healing and wholeness, that blessing that comes through from him to us. It's a moment that fills us with hope and inspiration, his direct blessing to us. So instead of just letting it wash over our heads this year, let's receive it with open hands and with an open heart, and let that blessing really come into ourselves and change us from the inside out. And then in the strength of that blessing, may we become a blessing for others. May we pour out that goodness, that divine spark to others so that they can experience the blessings of Christ. So this passage highlights all the blessings that we have been given. It's quite remarkable, and let us take them in. The first one is the gift of the resurrection. This has happened after Jesus has risen from the dead. It's a resurrection appearance. He has conquered death. Here he is among his disciples, and he is alive. It shows us that he's our Savior. He saves us as we move from this life to the next in the presence of God at our death. And he's also our Savior because he makes us strong enough to face the situations that we find ourselves in. So he has conquered death. And God, in God's amazing love for us, has conquered even the power of death. So it's a wonderful gift, this gift of the resurrection that we can hold on to. The next gift, the next blessing, is the gift of peace. The disciples are cowering in a locked room. They are so frightened. They are in fear for their lives. They wonder if the same thing that happened to Jesus will happen to them. And they must be full of guilt, too, a sense of why didn't we have the courage to stick with Jesus at his last moments when we could have been a comfort to him, and the shame of that cowardness that they showed. So they really need peace. Jesus enters that room, a locked room, mysteriously. We don't know how, and even his appearance is mysterious. He has the wounds of his experience of death, but somehow he's not quite as recognizable. It takes a while to understand who they are really looking at. And the first thing he says to them is the most amazing part. Instead of rebuking them for being cowardly and not standing with him in support of him when he was dying, instead of saying how disappointed he was in them, he says, "Peace, peace be with you." He gives them the blessing of peace. And peace means much more than absence of conflict. Peace in this context, what Jesus is giving to the disciples, is may God give you every good thing. It's a blessing to them. It's to strengthen them and give them hope and healing, restore them to being his beloved disciples so that they can have the courage to go forth in mission. Much more than just absence of conflict, this whole goodness that he is pouring out to them, his divine goodness on them. Peace be with you. He entered in a locked room. Somehow he came through that locked door and was among them. speaks to us of the fact that when we are in terrible difficulties and struggles in our life, Jesus finds us out. He seeks us. He searches for us. He looks for us beyond our fears and our failures, and he wants to be with us in those times when we are suffering. The next great blessing that this passage shows us is the gift of the Holy Spirit. The gift of the Holy Spirit. They're really frightened. And the Holy Spirit had been promised to them when Jesus was with them a lot in his earthly life. He'd promised that when he left, he would send them the Advocate, also known as the Comforter or the Helper. And an advocate in their legal system was someone who stood resolutely beside you as you were on trial. And they helped you defend yourself. They gave you comfort. They gave you the strength to say the words that you needed to say in defense of your own position. So he was sending them the Advocate, the Helper, the Comforter. And he does it in the most intimate way. He breathes on them. He breathes on them and gives them the Holy Spirit. And we are to remember the time when God created human beings, that God breathed on the very first person, breathed on Adam. God created him through breath. And it's this very same Greek word that is used here when Jesus breathes on the disciples and gives them the Holy Spirit. So in this moment, we're to think of Adam being created by God, and now these disciples from a frightened group are being recreated through Jesus' breath into people with a heart of meaning and purpose, a community of faith that's been given a mission to go forth into the world hungry for good news. Jesus said, "As the Father has sent me, I send you." So they've been sent by Jesus with a message, the message of the good news that God loves us, our sense that we can count on that love no matter what. The good news of the gift of the resurrection, that when we die, we move from this life into the presence of God. The good news of the kingdom of God, the kingdom of justice and peace and love that started with Jesus and is slowly but surely coming into being. So he gives them this, the Holy Spirit gives them a mission and a message to go forth into the world. And through them, us. That is our responsibility as the church, to take on that mission and to take on that gift of the Holy Spirit. With the Holy Spirit comes the gift of forgiveness, so that we can move forward into our lives, dropping our baggage of shame and guilt, so that we can put all that behind us. Of course, it's God who forgives, but we have been given a kind of a proxy at this moment. Jesus says to them, "If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." Well, I've always been bothered by that retained part. So I found a translation, Eugene Peterson, in the Message that goes like this. If you forgive the sins of any, they are gone for good. If you retain the sins of any, what are you going to do with them anyways? So this idea that our sins are forgiven by a loving God. Would you please show the picture of Thomas? There's a famous painting of Caravaggio's of Thomas needing the physical proof and Jesus giving it to him. Thomas, we can see how these blessings that Jesus is giving to the disciples works out. He was really skeptical. When they told him they had seen the risen Lord, he wouldn't believe it unless he had this physical proof. And when he had that physical proof, as we see in the picture, he was so full of hope that he called out, my Lord and my God. It's like he's the first person, he is the first person to really understand what it means that Jesus has risen from the dead, that there is this deep interconnection between Jesus and God, that Jesus is Lord, my Lord and my God, and that Jesus is like a window to God. So when we see Jesus in action, we know what God is like. So he moves from this position of extreme skepticism to extreme passionate belief, my God and my Lord, and becomes an inspiration for us. It's like he's been transformed from the inside out. He got this courage. He got this new position. He moved from a very false understanding, it can't be happening, to the truth. Jesus is risen. But the very most beautiful blessing that we receive in this small passage, I think, is the gift of Scripture. St. John tells us that he was writing his whole gospel to bring us to faith. He wasn't writing a biography. He wasn't giving us moments out of Jesus' life that are very interesting so that we'll be curious or interested. No, he picked out the parts of Jesus' life that were to bring us to faith, that were to make us so excited, that were to make us so compelled by him, that were to convict us and convert us, and to make us be able to say, my Lord and my God, to love Jesus with all our heart and with all our mind and with all our strength and with all our soul. He's giving us this gospel to bring us to that kind of faith. So today in this small passage, we have many, many blessings. We have the gift of the resurrection. We have the gift of peace, that inner harmony, so we can face situations in our life with equanimity. We're given the gift of the Holy Spirit, empowering us, enlivening us, comforting us, supporting us. We're given the gift of forgiveness so that we can be like Thomas, move from a position of skepticism to faith, and given the gift of the Holy Spirit, the gifts of Scriptures. So today we give thanks for those many blessings. Thanks be to God. Amen.
多謝光牧師的講道，我而家咧係誒摘要咧係廣東話嘅翻譯。聽日就好緊要一日啦，係嘛？因為咧係日全食，啊日全食咧就係即係我哋咧人生裏邊咧得一次機會喺我哋嗰個嘅範圍裏邊，日頭咧可以有機會睇到嘅。 咁咧就係希望大家都係有機會睇啦嚇，或者咧戴保護眼鏡眼鏡，或者你整一啲特別嘅嘢咧，可以睇到嗰個日全食嗰個影子，或者你啊睇電視睇都唔定啦嚇。咁咧但係總言之咧係一個好特別嘅係獨特嘅一個經歷。咁咧佢就話喺呢個經歷裏邊咧，因為係無論我哋喺邊個地方嚇，我哋咧都係一齊嚟到體會噶嘛。 所以有一個咧，除咗我哋個人嘅驚喜同埋咧個人嗰個嘅覺得個奇妙之外，個人咧得到一個體會到自己嘅渺小，呢個咧宇宙嘅偉大、上帝嘅奇妙啊！我哋更加係對人咧係有關心、有同情心，亦都係一個整體嘅大家一起嘅一個經歷嚟嘅嚇，一齊咧去體會。咁呢個就係一種嘅祝福。 呢個咧就好似咧，我哋今日呢段經文咁樣講，係咧我哋呢個嘅耶穌基督嘅顯現，係對呢一班門徒，而呢班門徒咧同時嘅去經歷嚇。咁咧關牧師咧係今年係再思想呢段經文嘅時候咧， 佢好體會到啊喺呢度俾我哋嘅係何等大嘅祝福，何等多嘅祝福。復活嘅主對多馬話：你因睇見了我先至信，那沒有睇見就信嘅有福了。嗰啲沒有睇見嘅就信嘅係咩個啊？就係你同埋我啦嘛，就係你同埋我，耶穌係祝福緊你同埋我。佢係傾倒出佢呢啲神圣嘅美善喺我哋嘅身上，就係佢同在嘅祝福，佢良善嘅祝福。呢啲喺我哋里边系会引发出生命，引发出力量，引发出医治同埋勇气。当耶稣基督咁样样祝福我哋嘅时候，我哋咧千祈唔好咧水过鸭背咁样话，我哋咧要大大张开我哋嘅手去领受主呢啲嘅恩典。不单止系咁样，我哋领受呢啲嘅恩典同埋祝福同埋呢啲嘅礼物入去我哋内心嘅深处，叫我哋嘅灵系得到是祝福，同埋咧叫我哋咧系有盼望，充满我哋主赐嘅爱同埋平安，我哋同埋咧系以感恩去回应，咁样就会培养喂养我哋里边嘅良善，使我哋都能够成为其他人嘅祝福。呢、这个复活嘅记载凸显咗主俾我哋一连串嘅祝福礼物，首先就系复活嘅祝福，呢、这个系连贯其他一切的祝福的。他耶稣基督从死里面复活多次显现给门徒看，是显明他是真的救主，他胜过死亡，所以能够拯救我们超越死亡。同时他也是今生今日拯救我们，耶稣基督和我们是建立关系，使我们给我们有力量和勇气，使我们可以面对任何的境况同埋挑戰。第二個祝福係平安嘅禮物。當啲門徒匿埋、閂埋門，佢哋好驚猶太人，佢哋好驚自己都被捉，佢哋亦都係驚咧，係覺得自己係好冇用。耶穌基督係死啦嘅時候，佢哋咧係四散嚟到逃走啊！佢哋咧係唔敢嚟到站出嚟，唔敢去陪耶穌、鼓勵耶穌。耶稣他们都是失去了他们的主，所以在这些的情况里面感到很失落，感到很懦弱和羞耻。但是耶稣竟然显现在他们中间，更加奇妙的就是耶稣显现的时候是他讲的说话不是哇对你们真的失望了或者指责他们，而是安慰和鼓励的说话，愿你们平安。这句说话是医治他们的心灵，确定和恢复他们门徒的身份，更加是给他们勇气去面对恐惧。复活主这第一句说话，现在今天就是成为我们礼仪里面的平安礼，是愿主的平安常与你们同在。这个平安不单只是指没有纷乱或者冲突，更加是指到上帝的赐给我们一切的美好，这个是从神而来的祝福，是主深切渴望我们内心有和谐，可以安然地面对一切的艰难境况。耶稣显然在这些惊慌沮丧的门徒当中，正正是提醒我们，在我们的困难和恐慌和绝望里面，主仍然是和我们同在的，是穿过我们的失败、失丧和失望，是进入到我们的深处，去肯定我们上帝对我们不离不弃的爱，我们仍然是天父爱锡的子女，再一次肯定神的信实。第三个祝福我们的礼物是复活的主给我们圣灵。耶稣基督向门徒吹一口气说，你们受圣灵。其实耶稣以前他钉十字架之前已经应许说他要赐圣灵作为礼物了。耶稣基督又称圣灵是真理的灵，解明真理的灵，是安慰的灵，帮助的灵，还有保卫师。什么叫保卫师呢？ Advocate 就好像当时的律师那样，好像律师那样是坚定不移的， 站在我们旁边的，为我们辩护的，给我们保护的，给我们支持的那一位。耶稣基督赐圣灵还是用一个很亲切好的行动来到去给的，就是向门徒吹一口气。这个令我们想起创世纪里面上帝造人的时候，做亚当的时候，是不是向他吹一口气，亚当就有这个生命了。这个圣灵就是同气，是同一个字，上帝的气，上帝的灵创造了人，耶稣基督的气，耶稣基督所赐的圣灵再造了人，成为新造的人。这一班自己闩埋门躲埋的门徒，耶稣的气圣灵再造了，由一个惊惶失措彻底失望的一班人，变成为有信仰、有信心、有使命、有目标的一个群体。这个群体耶稣基督的跟随者是被委以重任，即是说我们，你和我，是被委以重任，奉神圣的差遣去将神的爱、世人的福音带给更多的人。这个好消息带来复活的应许，这个好消息就是上帝的公义、仁爱、和平的国度由耶稣开始了，将会完全的实现。耶稣向门徒呼一口气，就是一个差遣，教会就是继续这个被差遣的使命，你和我就是领受了这个使命。第四个耶稣基督祝福我们的礼物就是赦免，我们得蒙赦免，让我们可以放低这个罪疚自责的包袱，放低羞耻的重担，可以抬起头来，可以向前行。只有神才可以赦免人，但是我们这些已经被神赦免的人，是好像被交付了一个委托去赦免其他的人。和合本呢这样讲，你们赦免谁的罪，谁的罪就赦免了；你们留下谁的罪，谁的罪就留下了。这句说话是很难解的，是关牧师提到有一个的意译， Eugene Peterson 的 The Message， 那个意译是很有意思的，让我们 去思想的，就是如果你们赦免人的罪，那个罪就消除了。如果你不赦免人家的罪，那你要留下那些罪来做什么呢？以上的各样的祝福礼物在门徒多马的生命上带来了无比的改变。当耶稣第一次显现的时候，多马不在这里，不在场，所以他怎么都不信。他说我没有亲眼见到他手上的钉痕，用指头探入那钉痕，又用手探入他的肋旁，我总不信。过了八日，门徒又聚集的时候，多马那时在这里，耶稣再一次显现，再一次说愿你们平安，对多马说伸过你的指头来摸我的手，伸出你的手来探入我的肋旁，不要疑惑，总要信。多马怎样回应？多马说我的主，我的神。虽然只是几个字，但是这个是约翰福音的结论，是整个约翰福音，是约翰想表达耶稣基督是神，耶稣基督是主。只有最后这个所谓多疑的多马，他是第一个真正领会、明白和说出来的。不单是约翰福音，其实四本福音书里面，多马是第一个，可以说是当在福音书里面唯一一个说我的主、我的神来到去称呼耶稣。你说多大的转变啊？这个多马有一个怀疑的，有一个不肯信的，有一个很多的问题，很多的不去听其他的门徒那个的见证，有一个这样的人变成一个是第一个去向耶稣来到去敬拜的人。这个是在他生命里面完全的转化，一个很大的祝福。你愿不愿意 有这个祝福呢？你愿不愿意领受这个祝福呢？最后这段短短的经文还有一个礼物，就是讲到圣经是神所赐给我们的礼物，这个宝贵的圣经。约翰在这里最后那几句话就是说，虽然写了这么长，但是他不是要写耶稣的传记那么简单，不是只是写一些故事，耶稣这么多的这个生平里面他选择出来是记载在这里，是叫我们可以信耶稣，也都因为信耶稣去得到生命。所以我们得到这个礼物圣经，就是叫我们可以认识耶稣基督，透过他认识上帝。你愿不愿意接受这个礼物呢？我们今天所看到的复活的礼物、平安的礼物、圣灵的礼物、罪得赦的礼物、圣经神的话的礼物，我们得以信耶稣基督，让我们的生命是得到转变，肯定我们是天父的子女，也都让我们有勇气去祝福其他的人。求主帮助我们，让我们是同心祈祷领受这个礼物。 Let us pray in the word of today's collect. 全能永恒的上帝啊，你是信靠者的力量，是怀疑者的盼望。求主使我们这些未曾眼见的人能有信心去领受基督全备的祝福，祂是复活的主，与圣父圣灵同一上帝一同掌权，从今直到永远。阿们。
继续增强我们的信仰，请立我们读读使徒信经。我们承认洗礼时的信仰话，我信上帝全能的父是创造天地的主，我信我主耶稣基督是上帝的独生子，因圣灵的能力成人，由童贞女玛利亚所生，他在本丢比拉多手下受难，被钉在十字架上受死埋葬，降至阴间，第三天复活升天，坐在圣父的右边，他将要再来审判活人死人。我信圣灵，我信圣义公的教会，我信圣徒相通，我信罪得赦免，我信身体复活，我信永生。阿们。现在是代祷的时间。
亲爱的上帝天父，我们要感谢赞美你，耶稣基督从死里复活完成救恩，我们得以和你和好，享有莫大的福分。所以我们行事为人要与所得的恩相称，承认自己的过犯，恳求神的赦免。慈悲仁爱的主，垂听我们的祷告。为患病的教友廖陈年爱、冯少杰、Vincent Yik、Justin Zhang 及患病的教友和亲友，求主医治安慰。为仍在治疗或康复中的教友麦心希、麦王妙基、周李绵绵、列伟如、陆丽婷、邓敬文，求主保守看顾，赐信心同力量。为出门教友汪日升夫妇同 Amit Wong 旅途平安顺利，慈悲仁爱的主，垂听我们的祷告。为生日的教友林妙英、Burden Knight、Jessica、Samantha Wong， 祝福各人生活满有主爱，喜乐安康。为圣坛献花，温如口甜感恩。廖陈年爱纪念先父母 陳李仙先生、王桂女士，子陳愛剛女士，兄陳洪恩先生，在堂萬寧紀念鄧周錫允，主懷安息。林麗智紀念 Karen Sim。 慈悲仁愛的主，垂聽我們的禱告。為聖約翰堂事工，為在主復活日來到教堂的聖人和孩童們祈禱，願他們在這裡體驗到上帝的愛，並接受耶穌基督的光。為透過英語班、香港新移民事工、體育事工和其他事工和我們聯繫的人們祈禱，願我們成為上帝愛和祝福的管道。為我們本周六的全體義工侍奉人員退休會祈禱，願更多事工來參與，並在退休會中得到祝福和更新。主啊，求你親手帶領聖約翰堂各樣事工，讓我們成為流通的管子，將你的愛和真理傳給尋求和有需要的人。慈悲仁愛的主，垂聽我們的禱告。為 York Mills 聯區、為北約克全科醫院和 Extended Care Bayview 的醫護和工作人員、院牧事工和崇拜事工，求主看顧、祝福和帶領。為社會世界以下的需要祈禱，為世界和平，願戰爭的禍害得以停止，新的戰爭不致發生，為和平談判的進展得到有效的成果，為在加沙和其他戰爭地區缺乏食物和醫療的人們祈禱，求主憐憫，亦都為那些努力幫助他們工作的人的安全祈禱，求主保守。慈悲仁愛的主，垂聽我們的禱告。神是光，照進世界一切的黑暗，將永遠的生命賜給我們，我們要喜樂、感恩、歌頌、讚美。以上的禱告是奉主耶穌基督的聖名而求，阿門。
請會眾繼續祈禱。主內親愛的朋友，上帝的愛是信實，祂的憐憫是無窮盡的。祂歡迎罪人並邀請他們與祂坐席，讓我們在上帝的饒恕中承認我們的罪過。最慈悲的上帝，我們承認在思想、言語或行為上常常得罪了你，應做的不做，不應做的反去做，我們沒有盡心愛你，也沒有愛人如己。現在我們痛心懊悔，懇求你施憐憫，為了聖子耶穌基督饒恕我們，好叫我們樂意遵行你的旨意，蒙你悅納而歸榮耀給你的聖名，阿門。
全能的上帝，施恩給你們，藉著我們的主耶穌基督，赦免你們所犯的罪，增強你們行善的力量，用聖靈的大能保守你們進入永生，阿門。請起立。 Please stand。 各位弟兄姊妹，願復活主的平安常與你們同在。我哋咧呢個嘅奉獻詩係咧係好短嘅三節嘅復活良辰歌第188首。 献礼祷文。满有恩典的上帝啊，主将我们从罪中释放，又将我们建立成为在圣子耶稣基督里面的国度，接纳我们今天所献上的，更使我们在你所赐的新生命中得到强化起来。奉主名而求，阿们。愿主与你们同在，你们心里当仰望主。我们应当感谢我主上帝，恩慈的上帝，我们应当称谢主，因为主创造万物，你照自己的形象创造了我们做男做女。当我们在罪恶中离弃了你，你没有停止关怀我们，更为所有的人打开了救恩的道路。你又同以色列民立约，藉着主的仆人阿伯拉罕和撒拉，应许万国得到蒙福，又藉着摩西的手带领你的子民脱离奴役进入自由，藉着先知你重新救恩的应许。因为这样，我们与他们和每一世代服侍主的众圣者一同称赞颂扬主有荣耀的圣名，说圣哉圣哉圣哉，天地万军的主上帝，你的荣光充满天地，在至高之处称颂主，奉主名而来的当受赞美，在至高之处亦当称颂主。我们可以坐下或者跪下，继续这个祈祷。神圣的上帝，生命和良善的根源，未造万物应当称颂你。到时候满了，主差遣圣子耶稣基督，并成为人与我们一样经历生与死，使我们能与天父上帝重新和好。他医治病人，又与被排斥的和罪人一同饮食。他开启盲人的眼睛，并向贫穷和缺乏的宣告天国的福音。在一切事上，他成全了你的恩慈旨意。在他自愿受死的那一夜，我们的主耶稣基督拿起饼来，祝借擘开，分给他的门徒，说：你们拿这个吃，这个是我的身体，是为你们牺牲的，你们应该这样做，来纪念我。餐后，他拿起杯来，祝借递给门徒说：你们都拿这个喝，这个杯是用我的血所立的新约，为你们和众人赦罪而流的，你们每次喝的时候应该这样做，来纪念我。恩慈的上帝，基督完美的牺牲毁灭了罪恶和死亡的能力，你叫他从死里复活，你赐我们永生。因此我们要宣扬信仰的奥秘，话基督曾经受死，基督现已复活，基督将要再临。追念他的死，宣告他的复活，仰望他荣耀中再临。父啊，我们奉献这些饼和酒给你，求你差遣你的圣灵降临在我们身上，又在这献礼之上，使凡在这圣桌吃这饼饮这杯的人都能成为一体，同为圣洁的子民，在我们的主基督里面成为活祭。藉着基督，皆同基督，在基督里并在圣灵的合一里，所有的荣耀都属你，全能的父，从今直至永远。阿门。The Lord's Prayer will be chanted. 主祷文。
Thank you.
我们擘开这个饼分享基督的身体，我们虽众仍属一体，因为我们分享这饼。主啊，我们与你一同死了在十架上，现在我们复活得新生命。我们与你同被埋葬，现今我们分享你的复活。求你住在我们里面，使我们亦都住在你里面。这些是上帝赐给他子民的圣物，感谢上主。
Thank you.
餐后祷文，各位请起立。天父啊，我哋亲眼睇到，亦都双手接到生命之粮，求你坚振我哋嘅信心，使我哋能喺爱你同埋彼此相爱之中成长。这都是靠赖我哋复活嘅主、救主耶稣基督而求。阿门。荣耀归于上帝，他能照着运行在我们心里的大能大力，充充足足的成就一切，超过我们所求所想的。但愿他在教会中，并在基督耶稣里得着荣耀，直到世世代代，永永远远。阿们。又愿上帝所赐出人意外的平安，保守你们的心怀意念，令你们晓得敬爱上帝和他的爱子，我们的救主耶稣基督。又愿全能的上帝圣父、圣子、圣灵赐福给你们，保护你们和你们所爱所服侍的人，无论在世界哪个地方，从现在直到永远。各位请坐。Again, thank you, Reverend Heather, for preaching, bringing the message. So many gifts. So we just open our arms and to receive. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yeah. 我们是很感恩一起来到去敬拜上主。接下来这个礼拜六是一个全体义工人员的退休会，那么是礼拜六上午九点半到晏昼两点半嘅，中间咧有简单嘅午膳，咁咧就系有个电邮吓，咁咧你喺电邮上边咧讲就参加就得啦。咁咧但系请喺星期三或者以前系讲，咁咧就系变咗我哋可以准备食物，系嘛？啊，咁其他嘅宣布事项，大家可以睇周刊啦吓。就第四頁嗰度咧有一個正念工作坊，我哋下個禮拜咧寫埋個英文來。正念咧英文叫 mindfulness 啊，呢個中文譯做正念啊。咁 mindfulness 係咩咧？你唔好問我，因為我唔知。所以咧，我哋請人翻嚟解俾我哋知啊。咁咧，我哋咧係歡迎係所有教友嚇，我哋中文傳契嘅團友，所有嘅教友嚇係用廣東話講嘅，係四月份。这个正念工作坊，我们很高兴是请到全员辅导中心的 Natalie Zhang 做讲员的。我们是四点正开始，之后我们是一起聚餐，每位聚餐是$15。如果是参加聚餐的，只是听个 talk， 你之后有事就不需要付费的。如果你参加这个聚餐，就是请同 Helena、Thomas 或者 Eudora 来到去讲，等我们确定人数。就是礼拜二之前，因為呢個係唔係呢個禮拜六啊？呢個禮拜六係呢個義工人員退休會，係英文嘅，但係歡迎中文堂所有嘅人咧參加。就呢一個團契咧係四月最撈尾嗰個 Saturday， 最撈尾個禮拜六嚇。咁咧就係喺23號星期二或者之前咧係報名。如果你食晏嘅説話，第五頁就係已經有其他嘅 detail， 大家可以自己睇啦。咁咧就係我哋好感恩啊！我哋睇見呢啲嘅主復活日嚇，咁多人參加呢個嘅崇拜嚇。疫情之後咧，當然有一啲咧係唔方便，唔能夠咧嚟到參加嘅，喺網上參加。但係咧，我哋亦都係好多人能夠係嚟到，我哋非常之感恩。今日英文堂咧有好多第一次或者第二次嚟嘅人，或者咧係。等等嚇，咁我都唔認得咁多啦。咁咧就我記名就好難拗啦。咁慢慢去練習啲名啦嚇。好，我哋咧係退堂師第一百 呢度咧有份四月份嘅金句喎，因為今日咧係四月嘅第一個主日嚇，咁咧就係四月份嘅金句，我哋一齊嚟讀啊，讀一次中文，讀一次英文。天使對婦女說：不要害怕，我知道你們是尋找那釘十字架的耶穌，他不在這裡，照他所說的，已經復活了。你們來看安放住的地方。But the angel said to the women, Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here. He has risen, just as he said. 我呢個禮拜五嗰個嘅電郵咧，係裏邊有一個嘅link 嚇，Henry Nouwen 嘅 link。咁咧就我聽佢呢個講道嘅時候咧，我有一個即係我深刻，當然有好多嘅好嘅信息啦。其中一個咧係提醒我咧就係、是、耶穌復活咧，啲男人走曬喎。四福音都係啲女人咧去見去揾耶穌先嘅，啲男人表示喺邊 ？OK，I was in the link to Henry Nouwen's sermon this Friday. Something came to me. It was a rich sermon, of course, but this particular point that all the men were gone. You mentioned that, right? but all throughout the four Gospels, it was the women who were sticking around and trying their best and doing things.Stuff. And so it's not just the heart, they're doing using the hands and everything. So as this verse has reminded us, 192, 第192首耶稣复活歌第一至第五节192首耶稣复活歌 Christ the Lord is risen again.
Thank you.
你们要奉复活主基督的名，带着祂的平安去进入世界，敬爱主，服侍主。哈利路亚，感谢上主，哈利路亚。